Here we have a cylinder of outside radius R1 and an inside radius of R2. We'll assume that it's annular, and a length of L. And we're going to look at a simplification of the heat equation, assuming that we have steady state, no heat generation. And so what we're left with then is that 1 over R d dr k r dt dr equals 0. What we want to do is find a temperature distribution for this particular situation given boundary conditions. The first thing that we're going to do is assume that our thermal conductivity K is constant. What that allows us to do is simplify our heat equation even more. So it's now d dr of R dt dr equals 0. Let's do the first integration, which involves this term here. And if we do that, we're left with R dt dr equals a constant. Or we can rewrite this as dt dr equals C1 divided by R. Let's integrate this again. And we're left with that T of R equals C1 times the natural log of R plus C2. So we have a temperature distribution. However, in order to be able to apply it, we need to solve for these constants. And because we have two constants, we're going to need two boundary conditions. And it makes sense if we go back to this, that we do our two boundary conditions at R1 and R2. So we're going to say that we have constant surface temperatures at each one of those. So we'll say that at R equals the R1, our temperature is going to be the surface temperature 1. And then at R equals R2, our temperature is going to be the second surface temperature. So now let's go back up here and apply our boundary condition. So that's going to leave us with two equations for each one. So the first one will say TS1 equals C1 ln of R1 plus C2. And that's using the first set of boundary conditions. Using the second one, TS2 equals C1 ln of R2 plus C2. The easiest thing to do to start solving for these constants is to subtract one equation from the other. And so if we do, we get TS1 minus TS2 equals C1 ln of R1 minus ln of R2, and our C2 drops out. And so we can write this as C1 ln of R1 over R2. So that allows us to solve for our constant. C1 is going to equal TS1 minus TS2 divided by the natural log of R1 over R2. Now we have our C1. Now we need to find our C2. And the easiest way to do that is to take one of our equations and set it equal. Now that we have our C1, we'll use the second one such that C2 equals T S2 minus C1 ln of R2. When we put these all together, we get T of R equals CS1 minus TS2 divided by the natural log of R1 over R2. The ln of R, which is the radius at any point in the cylinder, divided by R2 plus TS2. So here's our temperature distribution that we were trying to find. Now let's look at a couple other things that we can find once we have this temperature distribution. So the first thing is, let's look at the heat transfer rate. Q sub R is equal to minus K A dT dR, where our area is 2 pi RL times dT dR, which is just C1 over R. Where'd we get that? Well, if we come back here to our very first integration, dT dR is C1 over R. If you notice here, the R's cancel out, and what we're now left with is Q sub R equals minus K 2 pi L times this constant. And what this means is that this is not a function of R, so that heat transfer rate is going to stay the same as it goes through the cylinder. Now let's look at the heat flux. The heat flux is defined as the heat transfer rate per area, which is now minus K dT dR, which is equal to minus K C1 over R. And look what's happened here. Now our flux is a function of R, and therefore we cannot use it to analyze heat transfer through a cylinder.